It's been days now, and you change your mind again. It feels like years, and I can tell how time can bend your ideas.
Welcome back to RedBird Projects. Today I'm going to show you guys how to decorate your walls. And it's not going to break the bank. It's a good project if you're on a budget, student, or you just like a good old cheap project, then this is for you. So here I'm just showing you how you have to start the actual project above your head so people don't hit their heads. That is if you have a couch in front of your wall. If not, then no need to worry about it. So here I'm just sticking up the poster with blue tack. Blue tack works sometimes. It's kind of, I don't know, like it's a little, how do I describe blue tack? Like it works for some posters, like the coasters I use at the end to fill the space, it's perfect, it's fine. But with posters, I never have luck. It just does not stay. So if you're like me and you just can't put up a poster with blue tack, then maybe nail it in. I think that's what I'm going to do because this took me the longest part of the whole project. This was like 5 minutes dedicated to me sticking this up correctly. And then after I did all of this work, I was doing my homework and I was terrified when the poster fell down. I don't know if that's ever happened to you guys, but like you'll be sleeping and then you just hear the poster fall off the wall and then you just jump out of bed. Anyway, so this is the nails that I got. It's a little set. It comes with a little hook too. If you have a lot of frames that have a proper hook placement thingy-ma-bobby, then that's great. I ended up having to just use the nails for the majority of the frames. So you might just want to buy the nails without the, what is it called? Oh, I can't remember now, but just the smooth nails will do the job. And if you are going to do that, then you're going to want to nail at an angle. Like 45 degrees, just upright, and that'll do the trick. So, I mean, I have a sign here. The frame above the Fashionista sign, that was actually a mirror, and I bought that at Dollarama store. And it was, I don't know, like $1.50 or something. But it was a mirror, and my friend actually broke it. So she's terrified she's going to have bad luck for 7 years. But I actually like it without the mirror in it. In fact, it worked out because I'm terrified of mirrors. I don't know why I thought I was going to be okay with having a mirror there. But like small mirrors, I'm always scared that I'm going to look at it and see like a crazy person in the reflection. Like, you know when you just, those scary movies where they catch like a glimpse of the mirror and then they see someone else's eye or something? Oh my God, terrifying. So I'm happy I don't have a mirror there anymore. Not like that's going to happen. I know I sound like a crazy person saying that, but can you tell I'm just reassuring myself? Anyway, what else can I say? You guys are basically just watching me. You can't even see me right now. I'm figuring out the composition. You should do that ahead of time. I thought I did, but when I was doing it, I kind of thought over some stuff. So just, you know, get out a pencil, mark the middle of the frame so it's balanced, and just mark the wall and then nail where you marked the wall. I actually made a mistake with the white frame there. So the left side of that frame is being supported by the nail, but then the right side, I actually had to blue tack it. So, I mean, for that, that's fine. Blue tack is great. And the, like I said, the coasters, they're still up there. But with posters, I don't know. I can't do it. It just never works. So, and I even, you know how maybe sometimes stretching the blue tack first before you use it kind of warms it up, gets the stickiness flowing, I don't know. But I feel like that helps, but it didn't this time. So, so here you can see me nailing it upright. So you just want to hold it in place before you want to make sure you're holding it until about half of the nail is in the wall. Otherwise, you're just going to go all over the place. And you want to make sure that you're nailing the nail straight on. Otherwise, it'll start going all wonky, and you don't want that. So, pro tips of hammering right here on RedBird Projects, guys. Thanks, Dad. and this is not a fashionista moment. The outfit, no, just ignore that. This is me surviving Canadian weather at the moment. It is so cold, and I just resorted to the warmest stuff in my closet, even if the heater was on. so don't mind that. Don't mind the turtleneck. No offense to people who like turtlenecks. I like turtlenecks too. It's just maybe not that one. So here, I mean, you can also mark where you want the nail to go using blue tack. That also works. In fact, helping out with composition, I put blue tack on the frames and just kind of stuck them on the wall temporarily so I could see how it would look. That works too. And yeah, so that's pretty much how it ended up looking. So if you guys want to see more home decor videos, make sure you like this one. And until next time, thanks for watching and don't forget to subscribe. Bye.
It's been days now and you change your mind again. Feels like years and I can tell how time can bend your ideas. And the boys go on and on and on and on. And the boys go on and on and on and on. And there's gold falling from the ceiling of this world, falling from the heartbeat of this girl, falling from the things we should have learned, falling from the things we could have heard. Well, it's been days now and you change your mind again. Oh, the cracks in the walls remind you of things we said. And I could tell you